So let's think a bit more about XR experiences and where we can innovate and what we should be thinking about. So we need to think about the environment where our XR experiences take place. We need to think both about the physical and the virtual. We have, like in film, when you do a movie or when you watch a movie, you know there are like actors in there. So for our content, we need to think about how do we represent the users, and then how do we represent the characters in there that are 3D models or represented by data. And so we actually need to organize them in 3D space. And then we need to think about the interactions. And a lot of people think about just the clicking and tapping and gesture and voice and all these explicit interactions. But there is a lot of implicit interactions where people look, how people move, what they accidentally look at, what they accidentally walk towards, or intentionally, but more implicitly, these are interactions that we need to think about. So there's obviously all the content that we need to take care of, but there are like two concepts that I think are very important, context and story. So when we think about context, we need to distinguish a little bit between virtual reality, what happens there. And here you actually design the virtual environment. You are responsible for creating that environment that you will put your user in. And you have to make sure that it fits your virtual reality, fits within whatever reality, the actual reality that people have at home. Most of the time, for me, it started like laying out a little carpet on the floor, making sure that I don't step outside the boundaries and hit anything. Because design right now is really like assuming there's almost nothing physical around the users. And so we don't do a lot to keep users safe. And I think innovation needs to go into that space, really pushing, allowing designers to really make it easier to fit these environments, these virtual environments nicely with the physical world. So on the AR side, you design the AR environment, but you do it to blend with the reality. And so you think about this a little bit differently. You are actually designing not just have this little 3D model appear in front of the user. Oftentimes, that's what augmented reality does. There's a little thing appearing in front of the user. We have to make sure it actually fits within that reality of the user. And so our innovation needs to really go beyond just showing little 3D content in front of the user and getting them excited about that. That's the first step, but then really blending it with the real world. And then on the story side, just very quickly to highlight, actually, the best way to tell the story of a virtual reality experience is when you tell it at the intersection, really where this boundary is. Some of the best experiences I've had were like pressing virtual buttons that mapped onto physical buttons. And so it really was tangible and it was nice. And of course, there are people thinking about designing gloves and whatnot to make haptics a thing in virtual reality. But really, if we just design the story and at this intersection, then we don't need to instrument users with additional things. We obviously need to instrument the environment and map that. But then that is doable in many settings, actually. And so on the AR side, very important for us to consider that we're actually telling the story as the union. So you showing 3D content in front of the user is what you design, and then as a designer, you don't always have control of what the physical environment of the user is like. But ultimately, that's the experience you're designing. That content appears within the user's physical world, and so it needs to map.